Man, you got no sense of humor,
it's
asshole.
It's not that funny. It's not that funny.
Tell me this isn't,
Oh, for God's
sake. Isn't hysterical.
Don't tell it again.
What? You got three explorers in the Congo, right? They get captured by natives. Mm-hmm. Natives tie up the three whiteys. They bind and gag them, right? Chief walks up to the first explorer, and he says, you have two choices. You can choose death or Chi-Chi.
Okay.
First explorer didn't want to die, right? He says, I'll take Chi-Chi. 12 men grab him, rape him, sodomize him for hours, cut off his dick and his balls, shove it into his mouth, send it into the woods, bleeding from every hole. The chief walks up to the second explorer, and he says, you have two choices. You can choose death or Chi-Chi. The second explorer debates in his head. He didn't want to die. He says, I'll take Chi-Chi. 18 tribesmen grab him, rape, sodomize him for hours, cut off his dick and his balls, shove it into his mouth, send him into the woods bleeding from every hole. The chief goes up to the last explorer, right? And he says, you have two choices. You must choose death or Chi-Chi.
Yeah.
Sure. Third explorer, big macho guy, mustache, looks at him and says, I'll choose death. The chief turns to his entire tribe of 100 natives and says, very well then, death by Chi-Chi.
Jeez.
See, I told you I was funny.
No, it's not funny. It's disgusting.
Hey guys, it's locked.
Hold on.
Sorry about that. We didn't know it was locked.
You got a dead body, possible sex crime.
Can you give that to somebody else whose time isn't as valuable? We got like a million balls in the air right now.
Yeah, well, welcome to my world, hon.
Hey, boys. What do you say we clean up a DB by lunchtime?
All right, man.
Macho guy, mustache, looks at him and says, I'll choose death. Chief turns to his entire tribe of 100 natives and says, very well, then, death by Chi-Chi.
I was gonna kick out of that one. We just got it wrong, right? It's Kiki, not Chi-Chi. That must be some kind of white thing or something.
I got your message about Lemansky's wire mishap last night. Do you think your operation's compromised?
I swear I'm pretty good. I'm hoping we're still okay.
You're still making the same mistakes everyone else makes.
What is that?
I used to think that Mackie was the luckiest son of a bitch alive. And things just fell into place for him. And then I realized he was creating his own luck. So what you see is a simple microphone malfunction. I see as calculated.
The worst animal in the joint, 98% of the time, he's just like anybody else. Anyway, you see, other 2% that lands in Murray's, and I'm going to know everything about Vic Mackey. And when he goes into the 2% zone, I got him.
You still don't know who you're dealing with.
Or maybe you're still too convinced that he's evil 100% of the time. And that's why you keep grabbing for air, and he keeps slipping away.
You never looked Mackie in the eye, had him lie straight to your face, and made you doubt yourself, even though you know he was full of shit. So until you do, this is all just a waste of time.
I am so surprised that you're here.
Yeah, you knew I couldn't let go.
Well, Terry was your guy, so I understand.
Stop playing me and start worrying about Mackie. This could be our last shot at him. And I'm gonna be right here to make sure you don't blow it.